because at first I read that and went, how do I read that?
Yeah.
But so now the birth of Jesus was on this wise.
Yeah.
Okay. And then again, it would just be reading the sixth lesson, St. Matthew tells of the birth of Jesus.
Exactly.
Okay. I'm going to just show that to Louisa, make
yeah,
sure
absolutely.
She may be aware, hey, but just
in case. Let's show it to Rosaria as well, just to make sure.
Okay. Thank you.
baby.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. Welcome to St. Cecilia. Today we gather for this service of lessons and carols. This afternoon service gives us the opportunity to reflect on the incarnation of Christ and to prepare ourselves for the celebration of Christmas this week. For those participating in this service virtually, music and prayers for today can be found below the video on the parish website or by scanning the flow code. The service this afternoon includes 9 readings and musical reflections along with congregational singing of carols. We ask you to follow along in the worship aid and for those physically present to stand during the congregational carols. Before we begin our service, I invite you to stand and greet each other. Our opening carol this afternoon is Once in Royal David City, verses 1-5.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's nice to see you. Weren't we just here a couple of hours ago doing something similar, huh? It's good for us to be together this afternoon, and thanks for coming from near and from far to be together. You know, in this busy season, it's also good to just step back, right, and to gather in a place that we can call home, that's comfortable and familiar, that's hopefully inspiring, and I know it will be this afternoon. And just to kind of reflect on what it's all about and allow the Spirit to teach our hearts and souls. So thanks for coming from near and far, and it is good for us to be together. Am I supposed to start, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit? All right. Let's call on the good God to be with us this afternoon as we begin. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. So let us pray. Lord, we gather here this afternoon to slow down, to look within, and to recall the mystery of our redemption. Even though sin draws us away from you, God, you never stop loving us. The prophets, like Micah in today's earlier readings, told of the coming of a Messiah that would initiate a reign of justice, a reign of peace. This promise was the fulfillment and was fulfilled in the incarnation of Jesus Christ. Let us now reflect with joy on this wondrous mystery. Be seated.
The first lesson. God announces in the garden that the seed of woman will bruise the serpent's head. And they heard the voice of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God amongst the trees of the garden. And the Lord called unto Adam and said unto him, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard your voice in the garden, and I was afraid, because I was naked and I hid myself." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree whereof I commanded you that you should not eat?" And the man said, "The woman who you gave to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I did eat." And the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" And the woman said, "The serpent beguiled me, and I did eat." And the Lord God said unto the serpent, "Because you have done this, you are cursed above all cattle and above every beast of the field. Upon your belly shall you go, and dust shall you eat all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. It shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel."
Lord of mercy, despite our sinfulness, you never stopped loving us. Fill our hearts with your mercy, that each of us may forgive others. Amen.
The second lesson. God promises to faithful Abraham that in his seed shall the nations of the earth be blessed. And the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time and said, "By myself have I sworn, says the Lord, for because you have done this thing, and have not withheld your son, your only son, that in blessing I will bless you, and in multiplying I will multiply your seed as the stars of heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore, and your seed shall possess the gate of his enemies. And in your seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice."
Thank you.
So let us pray. Lord, you promised that your reign would bring the justice that would never end. May we help to bring this justice about in our time. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.
The third lesson. Christ's birth and kingdom are foretold by Isaiah. The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them has the light shone. For unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this.
So let us pray. Lord, we wait for the day of your peace. May we help to bring about this peace in our families, our communities, and in our world. Amen. Please be seated.
The fourth lesson. The peace that Christ will bring is foreshown. And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots, and the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of understanding and wisdom, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord, and shall make him of quick understanding in the fear of the Lord. With righteousness shall he judge the poor, and reprove with equity for the meek of the earth. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. And the cow and the bear shall feed, their young ones shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. And the sucking child shall play on the hold of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the cockatrice's den. They shall not hunt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea.
Thank you.
So let us pray. Lord God, you are always with us. May we always trust in your presence and share it with those around us. All through Christ our Lord.
The fifth lesson, the angel Gabriel salutes the Blessed Virgin Mary. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, you are highly favored. The Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary. For you have found favor with God. And behold, you shall conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then Mary said unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon you, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow you. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of you shall be called the Son of God. And Mary said, Behold, the handmaiden of the Lord, be it unto me according to your word. And the angel departed from her.
Thank you. Lord, you asked Joseph and Mary to trust in you. You ask us to do the same. May we come to share in their trust and always, always rely on you. All through Christ our Lord.
The sixth lesson. St. Matthew tells of the birth of Jesus. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, fear not to take Mary as your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son. And they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us.
Thank you.
So let us pray. Lord, you came to us in humility and in vulnerability. May we always show loving care to those around us who are vulnerable and in need. And we ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen.
The seventh lesson. the shepherds go to the manger. And there were, in the same country, shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And, lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for, behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign to you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, and the angels were gone away from them into heaven. The shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger.
Thank you. ox and ass and camel, which
Lord, you are the giver of all good gifts. May we always remember to share our gifts with one another, all for the glory of your name. Amen.
The eighth lesson, the wise men are led by the star to Jesus. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and are come to worship him. When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophets, and you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the princes of Judah. For from you shall come a governor that shall rule my people, Israel. Then Herod, when he had privately called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child. And when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also." When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
God of power and might, you truly are beyond all time and all space. May we never fail to recognize your majesty, and give praise to you in all that we do, in all that we say, through Christ our Lord.
The ninth lesson. Saint John unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of all the people. And the light shone in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all through him might believe. He was not the light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lights every person that comes into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the daughters and sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Oh, God, Almighty,
Lord, you call us to be your witnesses to the ends of the earth. Fill our words with power, the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your good news and draw all people to you. We ask all this through Christ, our Lord. I would just like to say a word of thank you before our final blessing. Rob, Thomas, our entire musical crew here, and you guys, I don't know about you, but I feel like I've just been kind of transported to a different place and a different time. Not forward, but kind of back, and it feels simple and good, and you are so generous in all that you have done with and for us today. So thank you. Truly grateful. And so I would like to invite all of us to come downstairs after this final blessing and join us for some great refreshment. There's a wicked awesome reception planned downstairs. And for those of you guys who are watching with us and here with us virtually, be with us in spirit, and thank you for joining with us this afternoon. Merry Christmas. The Lord be with you. May the good God bless us, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. And our celebration continues downstairs. Thanks be to God.